A few setting selections and actions taken by the host can help safeguard the Zoom experience. We'll focus on three steps: prevent, act, and report. One of the ways to prevent unwanted guests from entering your meeting is to configure a waiting room. All of your participants are placed in a virtual room until you let them in, either all or one by one. They'll see a holding message until you're ready. A second option to help prevent misuse by participants is to use a meeting passcode. When enabled, participants must enter it before they can enter the meeting or webinar. Note that, depending on your settings, passcodes may be separate from or embedded into the invitation link. If embedded, participants can still enter with a single click, so it's strongly encouraged that you use this feature in conjunction with a waiting room. Lastly, consider requiring authentication to join. Simply put, anyone who wants to join your meeting or webinar must be logged into a verified Zoom account or logged into a Zoom account that is associated with a specific organization's domain, for example, zoom.us or university.edu. Hosts can use all of these options at the same time to help safeguard their meeting or webinar experience. From your Zoom web portal, navigate to the primary menu on the left and click Meetings, then Schedule a Meeting in the top right corner. Among many scheduling options, about midway down on the page are checkboxes for waiting room, passcode, and authentication. For security and privacy, Zoom requires at least one of these options and has even configured them in your default settings with some variation by account type. Check any box to add the feature to the meeting. Keep the automatically generated passcode or customize it. It's that simple. From your Zoom web portal, click Settings, then the Meeting tab and Security. Click to toggle on waiting rooms and optionally specify which user groups will go into a waiting room using the checkboxes below. Next, click to require a passcode when scheduling new meetings. There are several additional passcode options here, including the ability to embed them in the meeting invite link or require them for webinars and more. Lastly, toggle on only authenticated users can join meetings and optionally specify a domain by clicking Edit next to the Sign in to Zoom within a specified domain section. If you've enabled a waiting room, passcode, and authentication, congrats! You've taken great steps to help secure your session. But for the unpredictable moments, Zoom's got your back with several in-meeting options. In the main meeting toolbar, click the shield icon. This menu is only shown to the meeting host and co-host. There's a lot you can do here, but make note of a few essential options. Lock the meeting with a single click so that no one else can join. Or remove a participant. They can't rejoin unless Allow Removed Participants to Rejoin is enabled in your personal meeting settings within the web portal. Should the need arise, click Suspend All Participant Activities to simultaneously mute everyone, stop video and screen sharing, hide profile pictures, disable chat and Zoom apps, and lock the meeting. Finally, users have the ability to report inappropriate behavior to Zoom's Trust and Security team. Zoom takes abusive behavior on its platform seriously and will evaluate misuse to take appropriate action. Do this during a meeting by clicking the smaller shield in the upper left corner of the main meeting window and then clicking Report. The host is able to select which participants they would like to report, include any written details, and add attachments. Or click More next to any individual in the participants list and then Report. Or, if you don't have time during the session, in your Zoom web portal click Meetings or Webinars, then the Previous tab, hover over a meeting or webinar, then click Report to Zoom. Keeping our community safe and happy starts by preventing, acting, and reporting.